Good morning, everyone. It's Tess, and today is take 44. And today I wanted to talk about how do we create a joyful journey, something that we can truly enjoy. And I guess what I started doing is doing some research a little bit on the emotional part again. And I know it seems like repeating patterns, but I think that a lot of what our issues are stem back to the same thing, but they get labeled differently along the way. And I do think that as bariatric patients, morbidly obese, super morbidly obese, I think that the biggest obstacle that we have to overcome is what's inside of our mind. And I guess today, in the past day, I've been looking at the idea of transfer addiction because that comes up a lot in our bariatric communities. And I started thinking about it and I'm like, that's really kind of still mind issues. And some of the research I was doing talked about how, you know, we all know our emotions guide us. And I've talked before, like with Doc V, we talk a lot about if our negative emotions are high, then our intellect is low and we tend to make bad decisions. In the Unlimited book that I've been working with Zahar, we talk about the emotional scale and that we make better decisions when we're in places of happiness and joy and love versus if our emotions are in a place of despair and fear and anger. So it's similar thoughts, but approached in a different way. And I think maybe we're all in different places in this world. So we've got to find the approach that will guide us and help us on this journey. And it made me start thinking about transfer addictions. And when I was looking at research on transfer addictions, it really talks about that a transfer addiction is simply our way of dealing, and it's not, there's nothing simple about it. I don't mean that. And again, this is just, I am not a professional. I'm just somebody who's trying to learn about my own journey and trying to improve my life going forward. But in doing some research on the internet, it talked about how a transfer addiction is where we take negative emotions and we participate in destructive behavior. Well, becoming super morbidly obese is a destructive behavior because it destroys our health, it destroys our self-worth, it destroys our joy, it destroys our happiness. Well, what happens is, and I've seen this in some of the support groups before COVID, you know, some of us end up transferring that addiction and that whether you want to call it addiction or not, it's transferring the behavior that destroys our self-worth. And we transfer it into things like overworking and food and alcohol and drugs and gambling and shopping. So whether you want to call it an addiction or just the way that we choose to cope with negative emotions, negative behavior, negative thoughts, we're not pulling ourselves above that line into places of joy and hopefulness and love and trying to pull ourselves forward. We're choosing a different behavior that's still leaving us in that same negative place that caused us to be overweight to start with. And I guess it goes right back to we need to work on our self-talk, our self-worth, and pull ourselves up into a positive place. And right now, that's probably harder than any other time because COVID has isolated many of us who are very social and don't aren't able to connect like we used to. So I decided to talk about this today because again, I am not a medical professional. I'm just a weight loss patient who is 150 pounds down. And I'm gonna actually show you a picture from pre-surgery. I know I've shown this before, but that picture was me about 2 weeks before surgery. This was me 1 year after surgery. I am currently almost 5 years out, well, just short of 5 years out, and I'm over 150 pounds down. I have lost over 30 pounds during COVID. And it's a battle that I deal with every single day. And I know that through this time of COVID and learning and studying and working under Dr. Wong from, he was a bariatric surgeon out of Texas, and he's working to help patients understand the underlying effects of the obesity because he said, you know, we can all have surgery and revision surgeries, but if we don't deal with what's happening inside our minds, we're never going to overcome the obstacle completely. That's why so few people ever have the long-term success that we all go into this wanting. But it did make me think about this idea of transfer addiction and What does it mean to me, and what am I going to have to do to not face that? And I can see how it could happen because we are our own worst critics, and we need to recognize that our self-worth, our self-talk, our self-belief is on the wrong side of that line. It's drawing us down and into bad, destructive behavior instead of handing us up into a better life. So it is that talk of don't fall into the well, reach up and step out. And it's our negative self-talk, it's our negative self-behavior, it's our despair, it's our fear. Doc V also tends to say, be fearless. Don't live in fear, be fearless and keep pushing forward. And I guess I just want to kind of remember that if we want to succeed, the best thing we can do is keep our mind, and I struggle with this myself, keep our mind in places of joy and happiness. We want health and experiences, and we want to feel good. We want to smile. We want to be outdoors. We want to connect with nature. We want to find the things that make us feel good, because if we allow our lives to fall into that place of despair and fear and negative emotions, it destroys self-worth and we make bad decisions. So I got today, remember, find those things that'll bring you joy, bring you happiness, bring you self-love, make you feel like you're progressing forward. Don't live in that place of fear and despair and fall darker into the bad behaviors that caused us to be overweight to start with. I hope you find this helpful. We're not alone. Some days are better than others, but if you keep getting up every single day, Sahara is going to start a new 40-day cycle. She does I'll flip this around again. This is the book, Unlimited, and it does have a 40-day law of attraction workbook. Well, she actually has an online group, and if you purchase the book, she walks you through that book one day at a time with a live, kind of like Doc V does a daily live too. But she'll do a daily live kind of walking you through that book and trying to keep you accountable. But look for tools, things that will help you to be thinking about your life in a better place. Don't fall into the wall of despair. Don't fall into the fear. It's so exciting when you start to make those little steps forward, the baby steps to progress, because it doesn't take a lot. It just takes one small step. And if you never give up taking that one little small step, you start to build momentum. And a month, 6 months, a year, 5 years down the line, you're sitting in a whole different place than you ever dreamed possible. So again, remember from Doc V, be fearless. From Sahar, from Unlimited, keep your emotions above the middle line. Keep your emotions in a place of joy, happiness, and love, and reach up and make your life better today. Thank you. Have a wonderful day and be blessed. Bye-bye.